and the winner 2 years ago in front of a home crowd in Great Britain. Gold medal winner 2 years later in the teams here, Laura Bettensteiner, with Miss Rotheris.
Well, I'm sure she's going to move on from the ride she had day before yesterday. We know that she can really pull it out of the bag, and already the horse going around the outside, she looks like she's got it balanced better and ready to go, so fingers crossed we get another great ride. Such an exciting championship, so brilliant, just amazing.
But Dan, as we've been saying, these championships just get increasingly competitive, increasingly difficult to predict. That makes good sport. Laura Bettensteiner for Great Britain with Elf.
That's better. That's where she needs to leave in there, just up there and balance, and if she can just keep that. It's such a powerful horse. So far, this is another level up from the Grand Prix. That's where we want to be. You just got to wish all of these riders luck at this level. Running on 82% at the moment. That's a great thing about these competitors, you know. They have a day that isn't all they want it to be, they come back fighting. Great job. Real improvement on this massage and the balance and the carriage. Absolutely level pegging with the leader at this stage. She's exactly the same score the leader was on at this stage. Step by step with Adelinda. Nice. Come on, Elf. Keep it together. Good, good. Don't be greedy. Managing it so well. Steady. Oh, glitch. Just needs to go a fraction more out to her hand. Danger point with him if he starts to suck back a little. The canter should sort it out. Oh no, they have transitioned. simple thing to do. It's such an expensive mark if you don't get it, but that's the trick of it, that's the trap of it. I think he sort of gave the indication before that, and she was doing her best to get him set up. That's a nice half pass and a very good changeover. It's dropped down marginally low at 79% now, as compared to 80% of the Adelinda at this stage. Very well handled, to Tempe. Get these. Oh, mistakes. Mistakes in the ones. Manage, nice first pirouette. Get these ones. Just taking a hold of it, ignoring her aid. Okay, she recovered, but there were the initial glitches, and the judges will be aware of it. So, yeah, lovely pirouette.
Just below 80% at the moment, the average.
A bit tight in the neck, just a little bit deep, but very well maintained balance into the Piaf and out into the passage, and high quality.
Right, yeah. Medalist from Windsor.
Much happier.
Putting his hands up in the air.
But I think, unfortunately, I think the ones are going to be the expensive thing. You know, everything else was so, so good. And vastly improved, and so it's one Tempe, he just got his head down, a little bit unbalanced, and even though she got the 9 on the centre line, there were clear errors in the beginning. It's wonderful extended trot, absolutely stunning.
Melissa Cornelison, current leader, 82.113. Laurel will be much more pleased with that test than the test in the Grand Prix.
I think generally, and very frustrated that she didn't get the ones, because I think she knows she was so close, yes, to actually being an 80%+. You know, the strike off into Canter, that was expensive. Very, very popular partnership there.
Gadget K's got her in first place at 84. A couple of 79s, a 78, a 76, a B.
Some adjustments going on our internal scoreboard here, obviously from the JSP, because this is how we've got used to it working.
Anna Davis. We're now getting ready, Utopia, with Carl Hester.
Still waiting for the score once all the adjustments are done. Yeah, don't mess with Alf, Mr. Stewart. Want to do it again?
.79196 into second place goes Laura Mettelsteimer.